Maria said, they are taking your regular old Christmas stocking and they are elevating them and making them something even a little more special, aren't you guys?
Yeah, we were actually inspired by the Hallmark Movies and Mysteries movie, The Magic Stocking, that's coming out. And I love stockings. That sort of movie got us thinking, like, let's do a little thing where we can each sort of, like, show how to make a stocking in our own style.
Yeah, and I think this is so great because, like, when we decorate, when we have stockings, we use them just as decoration, but I know a lot of people fill them, so I think doing some of this is just a really fun competition between us.
Oh,
it's not a competition.
It is, according to Orly.
It
is a competition.
Just saying, it's kind of a competition.
Game face on.
Is this like the 99-cent store challenge again?
Oh, the one I won.
Listen.
That I wasn't here for.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think we have to be the judges now. It's never a competition, it's a collaboration.
There you go.
Remember, we are all...
So who wins the collaboration?
We are all better together. You know who wins the collaboration? Probably Nick Lachey and his family, because I don't think you've seen stockings the way that his family has done stockings for years.
We do love our stockings, and we're one of those families that actually stuffs our stockings. Oh, poor Wookiee. See, even Wookiee gets a stocking. Wookiee's stocking used to be on the mantle with everybody else.
Yeah, but then you had kids.
We ran out of letters. The longest word we could get was peace. That's me and Vanessa and the three kids. So Wookiee's
Yeah, you've been doing it since you were a kid. Your mom used to put all the ornaments in it.
She gave us an ornament every year so that when we turned 18, we had our own little stockpiled collection of ornaments to start our own life with.
I love that. Isn't that great? Such an
idea. Way to make us feel like bad parents.
I didn't say I did it. I said my mom did.
Well, wait a minute. He doesn't make custom stockings, so, you know.
Oh, that's right.
True.
All right, so. Competition,
we win.
Exactly. All right, so let's start with Maria. I think it's no surprise that when Maria was coming up with a theme, hers had to do with cookies.
Yes, I am a cookie monster, self-proclaimed, by the way. I have just a plain white stocking, and this is a velvet, and I have some Hallmark ribbon, too, that I found that is, like, really pretty velvet that I thought went with it. Really
nice.
Yeah, so all I did was pop it under here, and... any chance you are a glue gun expert?
You know, I've got a little history with the glue gun.
Look at that.
How do I
know the thing?
So what you do is just put a little pull the trigger.
I'm a glue gun expert.
Bit of glue. So in this competition, that's good. It's good. Right. It just goes on just like
that.
So this is what I did to create just a little bit of a candy cane inspired, and you just continue to go around and around. And so instead of using a stencil, I found that I have about a bajillion little cookie cutters, and I found some felt that is the same color as a gingerbread cookie. So I used that as my stencil.
Such a good idea.
And I just took a little marker and drew around and cut it out like this, just like so. After that, that's perfect.
How far, is that enough ribbon?
That's perfect.
Great job.
Yeah. Be careful with that glue, Nick. It's very hot. It's around 98 degrees.
And so the rest of it is really just gluing on with the hot glue gun and adding little things with puffy paint. Do you know about puffy paint?
I don't.
Oh,
I'm learning now.
Some of 98 Degrees' band outfits had puffy paint on them.
Oh, I'm sure they did.
You don't want to talk about
it. Look at it. So this is what you do to it looks like frosting. So you add that on there.
And then, like frosting,
so this is something that really, for me, it made me think of growing up as a kid using my mom's little cookie cutters, and you can incorporate that as a little decoration on there.
But Nick, it would not be complete if Maria had not added something very special to the stocking, not just the cookies. If you would take a look at our stocking over here on the mantle, that was actually made for you.
Nick, I like to label things.
And you spelled my name right.
I like to label things. So I labeled your stocking. That is for you to take home to add to your no room on your fire. That just goes to a different.
Well, I can hang that with Wookiees out in the
hallways. Right, there you go. Christmas in July, you actually get gifts for Christmas in July, so you'll be leaving here with a whole sleigh full of things. This is true. All right, now Orly, I wasn't surprised to know that you would be adding glitter on yours as well because
can't help myself.
Well, you were.
I see sequins. I go to it like the sun. So I decided to make kind of a really glamorous, fun version. And whether you're doing the one here that's on the mantle that you can see, the bottom is sort of a lace with sequin on it, and then the fold down part on the top is a solid sequin.
It's so gorgeous.
It's really fun, and the fabric that you choose can be entirely dependent on your personal style, the decor you have. So this is the one I want to show now, and you can see the way it comes. It's basically a mesh with the sequin on the other side, and all that you want to do is fold your fabric in half, take your stocking and lay it on, and just trace it, giving yourself about a half an inch to a quarter inch of seam allowance. You're going to cut it out, and you'll end up with two pieces that you know, are exactly for your stocking. You don't need to worry about the top because, again, it's going to get a solid panel.
Okay.
Now, when you glue it, we're going to use fabric glue. And what you want to do is glue one side first, whichever side is not going to be seen. So depending on how you're hanging it, because we're going to overlap. So what we're going to do is go like this and tap it down. It'll take about, you know, a minute or so to stay dry. Now you're going to put a little glue on this bottom one, and you're going to fold it up, and it creates a seam. And I'm going to work my way all the way around. Do it around. Now, when we're talking...
Are you sure you don't want to borrow the 98-degree hot
glue gun? I like that you took the low-hanging fruit this time. He's allowed to. He's allowed to take it. It's his band. So then the last thing you guys want to do is take your panel. You only need to buy a quarter yard of your fabric, which is great because it doesn't, you're not going to take that, cost that much money. Keep about 1 inch on the bottom and the rest on the top. Because the important thing is that not only do you fold this under to create that really nice clean finish edge, but you want to make sure to have enough to fold this over, because I'm just going to show you over here. The reason you want that is, you know, when your stockings are hanging, you can almost always see a little bit inside there. If you cut it right here, you would see the canvas, and it would give away that this was just glued on.
Sure.
So make sure you have enough to fold, but then that's it.
They're so glamorous.
Beautiful.
They're
so fine.
Well done.
I see Ken on the end of the table there with a like a full pelt. Very rustic.
North
and
Pole. It's very manly.
You know, what are you going for?
Your yak wool or whatever it is. I don't know if they have yak.
It's very revenant.
Reindeer. There you go.
Reindeer.
Well, I'm sort of inspired by sort of rustic, and I love like wool plaids. I love wearing plaid shirts. So I wanted to do sort of a whole assortment of them that sort of mixed and matched plaid, wool, and fur. So I went ahead. I actually made my own stocking, not this competition, but I made mine. All you do, trace out a stocking you already have, cut it out, right sides together.
All right, let's be clear. You didn't do that too much. All you did was cut a piece of fabric and kind of glued it together.
All right, but come on. What did she do?
And he made three.
Yeah, he made three.
No, three that are hanging. I'm finishing up my fourth one.
Okay. Oh,
so once you do that, you turn it right side out, and you have, right, you have your stocking. This way you can really have it match any kind of decor you have going on in your home. Get a fur piece that sort of coordinates with it, and I'm taking a page out of Ms. Orly's playbook.
Is that allowed in this collaboration?
Yes, it is. This collaboration. Because fur is tricky to sew, because you'll sew down the edges, it's much better to use glue, so then you won't have that issue. Go ahead, sew it all the way around. Make sure your edges, put the seam in the back, just like on your edge. And the same thing that Orly was talking about, make sure you leave enough when you tuck it in on the inside so that when it's hanging, you don't see it. So tuck that in all the way around. I have a swap out here.
And then you added tassels.
Right, exactly. You're all done there. Then these tassels you buy online, a little bit of nothing, all different colors fur. Get one that matches. A little bit of cording. They actually have a little bit of an elastic loop, if you can see in there. Just slip the cord through, and then with the needle and thread, all you're going to do is just sort of tack that right onto the end with a couple of stitches, and voila, as I said.
So no gluing.
Not three,
no gluing the
but
tassels.
Four stockings.
No.
Nice. You know what? That's just cheating.
Well, quantity over quality.